To all of you who have turned up today, thank you. Thank you for caring enough about our community to make sure that our voice is heard and that this very special part of Sydney, this very special place in our heart, is not lost. Thank you for joining us to save Woollahra, to say no to amalgamations. No amalgamation, not now, not ever, no way. Our community, our voice, our choice. Our community, our voice, our choice.
Thank you, Madam Mayor. I told you she was passionate. And I might just also point out that Councillor Zeltzer is the first mayor in the history of Woollahra to serve three terms consecutively. So that is quite something. Now I'd like to introduce you to my friend of many years and colleague, member for Vaucluse, our very hard-working Attorney General, Gabrielle Upton, who is in the Cabinet and uniquely placed to take our message to the Premier.
Well, good morning, friends. I believe that local governments are local. That's spelled L-O-C-A-L. They represent local interests. They are communities of interest. So friends, what does that mean for us, for those of us who are represented by Woollahra Council? It means we reach out to Sydney Harbour. It is our compass. It is our orientation. My early morning bike ride this morning took me back to my home in Darling Point along New South Head Road. It is beautiful. It is historic. It is our compass. It means we value our deep and rich heritage and history. Heritage and history that is directly linked with the foundations of colonial democracy in New South Wales. It means we fight to retain our history and heritage. Duntroon House, Babworth House, that first got me involved in a local residence group way back in 1990. It means the pilot station at Watson's Bay. It means the fight for Christina Stead's home in Watson Bay. It means the campaign that has been run at the moment to preserve the fragile natural beauty of Gap Bluff. Friends, we value and we nurture our lush, our tree-lined streets, the winding streets that sometimes frustrate us, yes, but they take us through peninsulas like Point Piper, like Darling Point. It means we see ourselves as custodians of the flora, of the fauna, of the beauty in our area, in our national parks, like that at South Head. Friends, today I will leave not soon off because I will have the privilege of being able to celebrate, hopefully along with you later today as well, the 100th anniversary of the opening to the public of Vaucluse House. William Charles Wentworth, whose ancestral home that is, was one of the founders of our democracy in New South Wales. He founded the Australian newspaper. He founded Sydney University. His portrait sits in the Legislative Assembly of Parliament, where I sit. I hope you will excuse me in leaving early, but with that, we are celebrating the quintessential fibre of the area we call our community. Friends, we value it all, we're proud of it all, and what is more, we welcome others to it. Whether it's to visit, and we do that very patiently at times, or whether in fact it is to come and join our community. I know because when I attend and write letters to our new people, who are our new residents in the area, they come from the far reaches of the globe. We are diverse, we are generous in spirit, in sharing our quintessential nature with those who come to join us as part of our community. Friends, I believe there is no perfect size for a community of interest. There is no perfect size for a council. And what works here in the area that Woollahra Council represents may not work for those who are three streets to our south. And I do believe that small can be effective. I'm only 5'3" and it is for you to judge, but I like to think I'm effective. Friends, let me be clear about my position on this issue. My position is that Woollahra Council should not be merged with other councils. If it has the community's support, and the numbers stack up. Let me say, there is no decision. For all the rumours that have been circulating, all the back chat, there is no decision. There is a process which the council has been participating very constructively in. We must wait for the IPART decision, which will come out on the 16th of October, and then it is up to the government to decide what it will support. There is no decision. So there are two big steps to go. There are two big steps to go. Let me assure you, Woollahra's council's voice, the residents of that council, are being heard loud, are being heard clearly. I am listening, and so is the government. We say in politics that timing is everything, and now is the right time to make those views heard again and again, loud and clear. And so I ask all of you here today, help me to help us. What does that mean? It means that we need to collect as many signatures as we can, and I know there are petition sheets here on the table. They've been at shopping centres, areas where the community spends its time, out through the council area. But we need as many signatures as we can gather so I can lodge a petition in Parliament, and I want to do that. We need those signatures as soon as we can. The more, the better. The more, the clearer. The more, the louder. Friends, I implore you, that is the best way right now to protect the community of interest which we all treasure. Thank you.
Clear.
Thank you, Gabrielle.
Waverley and the rest of us.
Thank you for those words. This is kind of fun. Perhaps we should do this again. I've never been to a rally in my life, but I'm kind of enjoying it. So over here we have tables with all the petitions. Please only sign it once, because it's got to be all above board. But if you haven't signed it, I urge you to sign them. Put your name and address, and if you, your email if you feel like it. And we have those tables here. The whole day we're here.